A whole tour of Microsoft Teams. If you're new to it, we're going to take a closer look at how you can actually use it as the hub for teamwork in Microsoft 365. And we're also going to walk you through the core experiences for group chat, collaborating on files, and hosting online meetings, plus how you can customize your workspaces with your favorite apps. And if you're in IT, we're also going to demonstrate Microsoft Teams end-to-end admin and configuration controls. Before we get started, please give Aya Tange a warm welcome from the Teams group.
Thanks for having me on the show, Jeremy.
All right, so Microsoft is all about making sure that we can be creative, build the best content, really collaborate, and then be creative with anybody that we work with, and do that all very securely. Where does Teams play a role in all of that?
Sure, so just like you said, Microsoft Teams is the hub for teamwork that allows you to communicate and collaborate in a single and secure location. So you can really think about it as a four-in-one solution. You have your messaging, which is your rich chat-based experience, your online meetings, where you can always stay connected, as well as your calling capabilities built on our worldwide network, and you have your native integration with the familiar Office apps. And of course, with all this comes your enterprise-grade security to protect your data, as well as your compliance and security controls that you'd expect with the Office 365 suite. And all of these experiences are built for the web browser, as well as in your apps. So you can use all of your devices running Windows, Mac, iOS, and Android. Also, recently, we extended the power of Teams to industry-specific workflows. That includes highly regulated industries such as healthcare, but also broader areas such as first-line workers. And you can see here on the screen we have Shifts, which is our new schedule management tool.
Right, and we recently actually published a show on first-line workers and those capabilities, and you can check that out on Microsoft Mechanics. But today we really wanted to actually focus on the office worker and kind of IT admin experiences. It's still relatively new. I think a lot of people are probably looking at and starting to adopt Teams right now. But how do you use Teams in your day-to-day work?
Sure. So let me show you. So here I am in my Microsoft Teams desktop app. And you can see here in the left navigation bar, we have activity, chat, Teams, meetings, calls, and files. And in the ellipses here, we recently have the Shifts experience added. So if you're interested in that, I highly recommend you check it out.
That's what we saw earlier on the screen
exactly.
With all the scheduling.
Yep. Exactly. But I typically start my day in the activity feed. And this is really where I see all my information coming in from my Teams. But I like to use the filter button to really triage the most important information. Mm-hmm. And my favorite one is always looking at my app mentions. And this is how I really create my to-do list in the morning.
Right.
Then I can jump to chat. And this is where I have my private one-on-one chats, as well as my group chats. And to just keep myself organized, I like to pin chats to the top that I use on a regular basis so that I can stay, you know, efficient, but I also have my recent chats right underneath.
Mm-hmm.
Then I jump to Teams. And this is really where all the collaboration magic happens. And you can see here I'm a part of a couple different teams. I'm part of like the Contoso IT team, and you can decide as an organization whether you want to have a team at a department level or at a project level.
Yep.
And every team has a set of channels. And the way to think about channels is really a shared workspace where you can communicate and collaborate in a single location about a particular topic. Mm-hmm. So anything Teams upgrade related will be in the Teams upgrade channel. And so you can see here my knowledge share channel is bolded. And that means that there's new information in there that I haven't read yet. And if there are extra decorations, that means there's an important message. Or if I'm at mentioned, you'll also see an at mark.
Right.
But so let's jump into this upgrade channel here. And you can see that there are a lot of rich conversations going on. Mm-hmm. And you can see here every conversation has a reply button. So that you can have all of your, you can thread all of your related messages together so that you can easily stay on top of things. And I can also like a message as well as even save a message if I want to go back to it at a later time. But I also work with people all around the world. So I've been working with Miriam here, and she's written back in German.
I speak German, so it sounds like she's pretty excited.
Oh, lucky you. I don't speak German. But now with our inline translation feature, I can actually translate her German into English. So now I know exactly what she's saying. And I love this feature because now I can collaborate and communicate with people all around the world, even if we don't speak the same language.
Very cool. And we support 44 different languages.
We do, which is really exciting. So I also work with external partners and vendors a lot, and so we want to make sure that we can also include them in our conversations. And so now we can do that using Teams Secure Guest Access. And you can see here Lee is clearly labeled as a guest, so you can easily know who's a part of your organization and who is not. So if I want to compose a message, I can use our rich text editing options. And here I can add a subject, I can use bullet points, as well as make the message important, even highlight things if I need to, and hyperlink text. So these are capabilities that we didn't have in the very beginning, but now we do, and I use them on a regular basis. I can also attach a file for someone to review. And to humanize the conversation, I like to use my emojis, my GIFs, and my stickers to keep the workplace a little bit fun.
Right, who doesn't love to use that?
Oh, of course.
So why don't you talk about attachments? Because I think a lot of people maybe come from the context of email.
Sure. How
do attachments change then with Teams?
Sure, so when I attach something here, it actually uploads the file into my Teams file repository, which is easily accessible here at the top. And the back end here is actually using is SharePoint. So you have all of your rich protections as well as your collaboration benefits. And so here you can have, because we're integrated with the Office 365 suite, I can upload an Excel document or a PowerPoint deck, and I can easily start collaborating with my teammates. But I do want to point out one thing, Jeremy, is if I were to add a file, like I am here, if I were to add a file in my private chat, mm-hmm. this actually still sits on my personal OneDrive for Business. But
Makes
if
sense.
I were to upload that same file into my Teams, that would be added to my SharePoint here.
OK, and the cool thing is, because we're using SharePoint effectively as the thing that powers all the content management and all the content services in Office 365 and Microsoft 365, now you get all of the audit, the controls, the compliance, things like data loss prevention, things like co-authoring, all that stuff lights up with SharePoint. So it really gives you that extra, basically those extra capabilities right here from within the Teams context. And the nice thing is, with all the way that you're using files and kind of storing files, even though we get all of that great benefit from IT and everybody here is in IT, the users don't actually see it. They don't know where the files are being stored. They don't have to know that their file's in a document library somewhere. It's actually just here in files or in the context of chats. It's super seamless for the average person to just pick this up and start running.
Exactly. But it's also important to make sure that our teams stay in the flow and in the context of their work. And one way that we're helping do that is by allowing people to actually customize their shared workspace. And you can do that now by pinning a file or adding a third-party app or service so that you have your content and real-time updates really just a click away.
It's really great here to see Power BI as a dashboard, but you can even get to Planner and some other things.
Exactly. So I love making sure that I stay up to date with my IT spend. And just like you said, with project management, I use my Planner all the time, so I have my to-do list and my completed list. But it's not just Microsoft applications. We can also click on the plus button here, which adds our tabs. And I can add third-party app services and tools via our tabs, connectors, and bots. And if you haven't checked out our app store, I highly recommend you do so.
Very cool. But why don't we keep moving down the navigation bar and talk about something important to everyone, meetings and your calendar. How does Teams help me there?
Sure. So Microsoft Teams has a complete meeting solution that supports sharing, video, and audio conferencing. So now here you can see my daily view of all my meetings. Mm-hmm. I can also schedule a meeting from the platform, as well as we just announced that you can create a live event. And this now can hold up to 10,000 participants, and they can participate in real time. So Jeremy, do you mind jumping into this exec review meeting here, and we can show some extra capabilities that we have?
Yeah, let's do it. So actually, here I can actually see that I've got the meeting scheduled for me. I can see all the different attendees. Chat with participants, so I can set up a text-based chat channel for those folks. Now, if I go ahead and click join, the nice thing here, and one of the things I love about Teams is, before I actually join the meeting, it gives me this pre-join screen. So it saves me in terms of if I want to mute my microphone, if I want to turn my camera off, maybe I just woke up or something. Maybe if I'm in a VTC room, I want to join with the audio turned off because it's coming through a VTC audio and video system. And one of my favorite things now with Teams, actually, and we can't see it here because this is the two of us, but if a lot of people are pre-joined into the call, it'll say, you're a bit late to the meeting, maybe there's five different people already on, we'll mute your microphone by default. So I'm going to go ahead and click join now. So when I join that meeting, I'm going to go ahead and mute my microphone. So when I joined that meeting, I can see that Aya's in the meeting. There she is. Now we can see on the two different screens, we have me on the left, Aya on the right, on my right, opposite if you're watching from that angle. And I'm going to go ahead and show what I can do also from a content sharing perspective. So here I can share my desktop. If I want to do that, I can share also individual windows using remote app capabilities just to show the window itself. And then even PowerPoint files, because these are part of my most recently used documents, they're surfaced right here. And that way I can actually use Teams native integration with PowerPoint Online to actually present that file. And if I want, I can allow people to even fast forward through that content. It's a really efficient way to do remote presentations.
So we also added the ability to record your meetings. And this is really helpful if someone misses the meeting or you want to go back and review it. I can also blur my background here and remove distractions behind me so that I can stay focused in on the meeting. And I use this all the time, whether I'm at an airport or if I'm at a cafe or even working from home. So I use this on a regular basis.
Sounds good. Let's sure. look into one. You can actually do some things in terms of using the captions and actually search through that content, right?
Totally. So you can see here that we recorded this Teams rollout planning meeting, and now I can click into it and watch the meeting in its entirety. But sometimes I don't have time or I really want to focus on a specific part of the meeting. And now with our transcription services powered by Microsoft Stream, I can turn on captioning on and see exactly what's being said. Mm-hmm. But I can also search for specific keywords. In this case, I'm interested in guest access. So now I can actually click into this and the meeting recording will jump to that specific point. And now I can pay attention right from here, make sure I have all the information and action items.
And it's really great if you weren't in that meeting or maybe late to that meeting, somebody mentioned your name. And you want to search for your
exactly.
name, for example. Really, really cool stuff to be able to search the captions and find exactly that point in the meeting. So can you tell us a bit more beyond kind of the meetings, what else we can do with Teams?
Sure. So we also, if you have PSTN calling integrated into your Microsoft Teams configuration, you now have all of your call controls here, as well as your phone number. You have your speed dial, your favorites, as well as all of your contacts, your call history, and your voicemail.
Nice. So switching gears, though, in terms of all the IT folks that are in the room, what kinds of controls do we have for the folks that are managing or implementing and rolling out Microsoft Teams right now?
Sure. So Microsoft Teams can be managed the same familiar way in which you manage the rest of your Office 365 apps. Mm-hmm. And don't fret for the security officers out there. The same controls that you are using in the Security and Compliance Center also apply to Teams. So for example, let's say you have a data loss prevention policies for your files. We now just announced that you can create data loss prevention policies for your private chats as well as your channel conversations. So we want to make sure we protect your information in all instances.
Right. And so if you're new to data loss prevention, what you can see here is this is a credit card number that basically DLP or data loss prevention policies detect right while you're actually chatting that information within Teams. We can do that now in email and SharePoint files that are stored and maybe in a document library. But now even in the context of chat, Teams will be able to detect that and obfuscate that effectively from the other side, the recipient, as you're sending that kind of information.
Right. But really my day-to-day management happens in the Microsoft Teams Admin Center. So this is really where I can manage all my aspects around Teams, such as messaging, meetings, and other org-wide settings. And so if you haven't been to the Admin Center in a while, we've added a bunch of new capabilities. So from here, I can check into Teams, and I can see every single team that has been created in my tenant. I can edit an existing one, where I can add team members or change channel settings, but I can also even create a brand new team from here. Then I can jump into users here, and this is where I can see all of the users in my Teams tenant. I can also assign specific policies per user as well. Mm-hmm. Then I'll jump into meetings, and this is where I can define conference bridges as well as other meeting policies, such as being able to record meetings and transcribe meetings.
Makes sense. Yep.
I can also create my live event policies here as well. Mm-hmm. Then I can jump into messaging, and this is where I can really define the chat experience someone will have. So I can decide if they can delete a message, or if they can use GIFs or memes, or even be able to translate messages as well.
Right.
And last but not least, the org-wide settings. This is where I can configure external access, guest access, but also if you are on the journey from moving from Skype for Business to Teams, we have definable coexistence modes. So now we can really help you with your transition.
Very cool. So it's great seeing all these controls and all the role that Teams plays in terms of making all these controls available to you and having all of that configurability. And all that, basically in a really short time, it's lit up. I've started following it since day one, and this is a lot of stuff that you can do now. Thanks, Aya, for the comprehensive tour of Microsoft Teams. But if I'm just getting started, I'm brand new to it, where do you recommend people go to learn more?
Sure. So first things first, if you are a Teams admin, make sure you actually enable it in your tenant. And if you need some resources, we have a one-stop shop at aka.ms/success-with-teams.
Great overview, Ian. And also, thanks for joining us. Don't forget to stay tuned to Microsoft Mechanics for the latest tech updates across Microsoft. That's all the time we have for this show. We'll see you next time.